Ndiwe Mazibuko, DA parliamentary leader. Her rise through DA ranks, meteoric. She completed a dissertation on the DA in 2007, was elected to parliament in 2009, and the rest is history. Last year, she humbled the DA old guard, winning handsomely against incumbent Ethel Trollope. Then Mazibuko reshuffled her shadow cabinet. Ironically, she moved Trollope to the position she had just vacated, Shadow Minister of Rural Development. Trollope effectively checkmated, he couldn't now complain.
When one looks at how a leader composes their cabinet, it is also a reflection of that leader's preferences and also the people that are close to that person.
The reshuffle was attacked by some DA MPs. Speaking on condition of anonymity, they complained they were moved without consultation. Mazibuko confirmed some had complained to Helen Ziller.
When you have 85 members who are very talented and who have lots of expertise to bring to the table, you're never going to be able to make everybody happy.
Mazibuko wants to boost DA support at the 2014 polls to 30%, and she's been groomed for the top post. Dissent in the party could, however, compromise this.
I think for Mozilla, this would be quite a big challenge to ensure that this does not undermine the bigger drive of a party forward.
Divisions within political parties are not new. It's affected the ANC, IFP, COPE, and the PAC. Still, there's no empirical evidence of just how deep the DA schism is.
DA leader Helen Ziller and Lindiwe Mazibuko have both refused to comment. Fractured, divided, and at war with itself. That's how Mazibuko described the ANC a year ago. In politics, however, things are always bound to come full circle. Lukhanyo Chalata, SABC News, Parliament.